Good morning to all the students of class plus 1B. Beta, as I already told you yesterday that we will be doing the writing skill today, notice writing, fine. And if we'll be having time, then only we'll discuss the question answers of voice of frame. Otherwise, let's do one writing skill, fine. So as I have already given you much time to note down the details, so keep your notebooks ready. I can ask any one of you to switch on the camera or all of you to show the notebook only whether you have written or not. So I would be explaining first the value points that are written here. And then after the value points, we will be coming back to the format of notice writing. You can score full marks in this composition. Fine. Otherwise, many students complain that, ma'am, we don't get full marks in any writing skill. But you need to take care of all the value points, the format, and obviously spelling mistakes and everything. Clear? Then you can score 5 on 5. Firstly, beta, we have name of the organization. So that organization is not always a school or a college or a university. Most of the times you have done in junior classes that school is going to organize this. Fine. It can be any NGO. It can be any society. Fine, it can be the colony where you are living in. Notice can be put up by any organization, whether it's a school, society, or any NGO. Clear? Or any, you can say, government. Fine. After that, name of the organization, we will be writing the word notice in all capital letters. Fine? Word notice to be written in all capital letters. Then we have third value point is title and heading. Title or heading. Fine. One and the same thing. So now about this, I would like to tell you, it can be up to 3 to 4 words. Avoid writing one word titles. Fine. One word titles are not accepted in this notice writing. So, and title should be, you know, catchy. And it should give a fair idea of what this notice is all about. Clear? Suppose some competition is going to be organized in the school, poetical recitation competition. That can be your heading. And means after reading the title or the heading, one should have a clear idea of the content of the notice. Clear? Drishti, you have joined right now. Jodhpreet also. So kindly take notes of the value points, beta. Others have already noted down. Clear? So after that, beta, title and heading, one should write up to 3 to 4 words and it should clear the idea of the notice. Then we have content. Now in the content, most of the students, you know, they face problem in how to start the notice. There are many ways, but the basic ways, this is to inform. Fine. This is to inform. 3 words you are writing here from the extreme left side here. This is to inform. Now, firstly, after writing this is to inform, you will be mentioning the target group to whom you want to inform. That is your target group. Suppose the notice is for all the residents of a colony. Fine. Then this is to inform all the residents of the colony. Suppose it is for the residents of first floor only. Clear? Then your target group is residents of first floor. This is to inform all the residents of first floor that whatever is, you know, content is there. Then I'm just talking about the very first line. Then suppose it is for a school. This is to inform all the students. Fine. All the students of the school. Then suppose this is for the 9th to +2 only. Some competition is there. This is to inform all the students of from 9th to 12th, that then you will be putting forth your notice, whatever content is there. Clear? So in the very first line, you will mention the target group. After that, or you can also write it is to bring to the kind notice of, if you don't want to write this is to inform. Fine, both the ways are correct. Then after that, you will be mentioning the content. That suppose a poetry recitation competition is there. This is to inform all the students from classes 9 to 12 that summer camp is going to start from 1st June till 15th June 2021. Fine. Now after telling what, I already told you in the content what, where, and when. All the W's to be answered. W means W say what, W where, W when. Clear? Means this way you remember that three W's to be answered in the first two lines of the notice. That what, political recitation. Where, in the school auditorium, maybe it's a competition. If it's a, you can say online classes are there, online hobby classes are going to start, then you will be mentioning accordingly, right? On the Zoom platform, right? Then we have when, from 1st June to 15th June. So you have answered all the facts and data in the first two lines of the notice. Then after that, target group, you have already, I have discussed about it. Other necessary details. Now, what comes in other necessary details? Beta, you cannot expect 515 without writing anything extra. Fine, you have mentioned what, where, when, and target group, but you need to put up some more information. Like, students are supposed to submit their names before 30th May to their respective class in charges, to the activity in charge. You can write the name of some teacher. Fine. And if it's a competition, or if it's you can say talent and competition, then students will be selected on the basis of these categories. You can say means any other. Suppose it's an annual function. So you can write students are supposed to be seated by 9 a.m. in the morning in the school grounds. Fine. In that way, you are providing some extra information, some other necessary details. Fine. That should be the part. And where to write those additional things after writing the main content. As you have been doing this in junior classes also, you can bifurcate date, time, and venue also. Fine, you have done it earlier, fine. Or you can write in running paragraph. Both ways are correct, but the all the W's should be answered. This is the thing. Clear? Then after that, beta, after the content is over, you will be putting signatures in running hand. Clear? So, after the content is over, I was discussing about the necessary detail in the case of if it's a function, then you can write about the timing that at this time you're supposed to be seated. If it is an event, students will be selected on the grounds of confidence, good communication skills. Fine, in that way, any other necessary detail you can give at the last. Now, the order of the content, beta, should be logical. Some students, you know, start writing the other necessary details in the beginning, and the major information, that is what, where, and when, that they just start writing in between anywhere, or they start writing this date on the right side, and then marks will be deducted accordingly. Here you should be very much particular about that, where to write the date. Date should be written on left side only. Clear? So there are four lines you can count on fingers. First line for the name of the organization. And if city is mentioned, then you will be mentioning the city in the same line, not in the next line. Fine. After the name of the organization, you will put a comma and then you will write down city. Clear? If no city is mentioned, nothing is mentioned, then you can leave this. In the second line, you will be writing the word notice with all capital letters. I repeat. In the third line, you will be writing date on extreme, and you won't be using the mathematical way of writing the date. Okay. You will be writing this way only, the way I have written. Fine. You can see 29th May 2021. Clear? After that, you will be writing beta the heading, and then comes the content. Clear? This is to inform, as I have already discussed with you all. Clear? Then signatures, and I just showing you signatures in running hand. The name should be legible. What is written, it should be readable. Signatures you can do in running hand. And then at last, in the bracket, I have written the designation part, beta. Now, what is a designation? Designation is the post. Suppose you are the head boy of the school or head girl of the school. Fine, in that way, you can write your designation at the last only. If no designation is written, you need not invent it. Clear? In the case of some notice from, you can say, manager, you can write the designation manager. If you are the director, you can write the director. If you are school captain, you can write school captain. It depends upon the content only. Clear? Okay, Drishti is asking to explain target group again. Okay, Drishti, you joined later, so I'll be explaining to you again. Now, target group is for whom this notice is written. Clear? Suppose this is the notice is meant only from classes 9th to 12th, then your target group is 9 to 12. You won't be using the word target group beta. Clear? You will be just saying this is to inform all the students from classes 9th to 12th that school activity department is going to organize hobby classes from 1st June onwards till 15th June 2021. Interested students may give their names to their respective class in charges before 31st May 2021. Fine? And Zoom ID and password you can share, or you can also mention that the online format will be used for this also. Whatever necessary information you want to give, that can be the last line of your notice. And at last, you will be putting signatures, name and designation. Is it clear, Drishti? Send me thumbs up if you have any. Okay, better, fine. Clear? So now we will be doing one example of notice. Kindly note down the statement, better. Fine, this is your homework, or you can say home task. You are the secretary of, write down the statement. I will be seeing the notebooks of all the students when you are finished with this statement. You are the secretary of the English Literary Association. Clear? You are the secretary of the English Literary Association of Tagore Memorial School. My voice is audible to everyone. You are the secretary of the English Literary Association of Tagore Memorial School, Patna. Tagore Memorial School, Patna. Write a notice inviting names of those. Write a notice inviting names of those who would like to participate, in the various inter-house activities, like debate, poetry recitation, poetical or poetry, both are correct. Poetical recitation and speech contest from 1st June till 3rd June. So now you just imagine, I was asking you to give the answers of W's. In this case, answers of W's are given in the statement. Dates are given to you. Contest names are even given to you. Fine, you can add up into it, but you cannot change the given things. Fine, you cannot distort it. Whatever is given, that you will be using. Debate competition, they have mentioned. Speech, they have mentioned. Fine, poetical recitation, they have mentioned. You can add up into it. You can add up elocution. Elocution is equivalent to speech only. Fine, you can add up more details or other things. Fine, you cannot discard the given statement. Clear? And dates are also given to you. So what will be the heading now? Raise your hands, beta. What can be the heading of this notice? Just raise your hand. Very easy. Firstly, though, we'll be writing the name of the school in the very first line where we write name of the organization. We'll be writing Tagore Memorial School, Patna. I start writing the notice side by side. Sahajpreet, we are supposed to leave line between name of organization and notice. But that is not mandatory. That should be two separate lines only, Sahajpreet. Okay. That will not deduct any marks, but in one line you will be writing organization. In next line, you can write the word notice. There is no problem. Yes, Japan is sending me the answer. Inter-house activities. Well done, Japan. Any other title? You can write in the chat box if you don't want to speak. Fine. Japan is sending me this, the title of this notice, inter-house activities. Any other title suggested by any other student, beta? In the first line, we have written Tagore Memorial School, comma, Patna. In the next line, we will be writing the word notice. In third line, date. And in the fourth line, inter-house activities or inter-house competitions. Because there are more than one activity. So you can write inter-house. Yes, Dia has already written inter-house competition. Fine. Well done. Clear? After writing this, beta, now the content part. Clear? Anyone who can speak the content can raise hand. I will just appreciate those students. Very good, Anjali, Manjot, Japan. Kindly raise hand. I will unmute you and then you can speak. What is to be written in the very first line? Very easy thing. No hand I could see raised here. Yes, Anjali, what happened, Manjot? First line of the notice, which we do in class 4th and 5th even. Just raise your hand and speak rather than writing in the chat box. You can participate directly by speaking. This is to inform all the students from classes 9th to 12th, target group you can set accordingly. Fine. If you don't want to set, you can write all the students also. Yes, yes, Japan, you can take any group. So kindly unmute yourself and speak. Those who want to raise your hand and I will unmute you. Japan, would you like to raise your hand? I just want active participation. The more you are, you know, getting into senior classes, you stop participating. I don't know why. So, I would be explaining, obviously, if you people are not willing to answer. This, you can say, you can also start with the English. Yeah, you are writing. This is to inform that inter-school competition is going to be organized in the school from this. Okay, Dia. Okay, Anjali. Fine. Those who are writing, better rather than writing such long answers, why do you hesitate? I don't understand. You should speak up. The English Literary Association also you can mention. I already told you, you can put up your more details. Clear? This is to inform all the students from classes 9 to 12 that English Literary Association of our school is going to organize and you can say various activities from 1st June to 3rd June 2021. The following are the details of the activities. Now, I have already mentioned three activities are there. So you can just write in the center of the content. You can write down an point A. You can make points, sub points also. Point A, debate competition on 1st June 2021 from 9 a.m. to 10 a.m. Fine. School venue, niche likh sakte ho, school auditorium. Fine. And then you can write elocution contest, or you can say debate, speech competition, vertical recitation on 3rd June in that way. You have just segregated the details because there are more competition. Then at last, you can write the interested students. You know, what funny thing, let me tell you, many students, they write, interesting the students can give their names. This is very wrong. Interesting the students. That there will be a big cross on this, you can say, box. Interesting students is not right. It's not correct. Interested ones. Interested students. Those who are interested in this competition. Fine. So the interested students can give their names to their and respective class in charges. Respective means your own class teacher, not to any other class teacher. So there also you just commit mistakes. Clear? At last, signatures, name and designation. Is it clear? Any doubt to anyone? Send me thumbs up. Come on. Then we'll move on to our, you can say, continuation with the discussion of question answers. Everybody is saying yes. So when there will be test, it should be, you should score full marks in it if you are sending me thumbs up. So today you have PTM. Before continuing with this, let me tell you again, you have PTM at 12. Your period ends at 11:25. Only 5 minutes are left. So exactly at 12, it is compulsory for all of you, along with either of the parents, means one parent out of the two should sit with you, fine, and attend the PTM and interact with the teacher. Then we'll be discussing the performance of the students and very important information I will be sharing with you. Okay, so it is compulsory to attend the PTM.